encouraging. Naomi said, Ruth, what are you following after me? You can return. After all, the only person you know, we're going to strength land. We're going to the land of Israel. And your sister-in-law is gone back. You can return. I give you permission to return. Look at verse 16. And Ruth said, entreat me not to leave thee, or to return from following after thee. For whither thou goest, I will go. And where thou lodgest, I will lodge. Thy people shall be my people, and thy God my God. I pray that God will give you that consistency and commitment and consecration in Jesus' name. Then it says in verse 17, where thou diest will I die, and there will I be buried. The Lord do so to me, and more also, if aught but death part thee and me. When she saw that she was steadfastly minded to go with her, then she left speaking unto her. That's the consecration the Lord demands today, and I pray that you'll be able to give yourself, your heart, your mind, your life totally without reservation unto the Lord and move on with the Lord in Jesus' name. In John chapter 12, I'm reading there from verse 24. Here are the words of Jesus Christ, the demand he makes upon the people that say they are following after the Lord. John chapter 12, I'm reading from verse 24. Verily, verily, I say unto you, except a corn of wheat fall into the ground and die, self, except it dies, self-will, except it dies, my own mind, except it dies, what I like, what I don't like, except it dies. It says, except a corn of wheat fall into the ground and die, it abideth alone. But if it die, it bringeth forth much fruit. He that loveth his life shall lose it. He that loves his life, and you are petting yourself, and you are taking care of yourself, and you are touching this and touching that, and taking care of this and taking care of that, and you are so sensitive, cannot preach the word of God to you. If we quote the Bible, you are offended. If we apply the Bible, you are offended. If we make any illustration, you are offended. Why did they talk like that? Don't they know I'm here? If you don't hate yourself and say that kind of pride and self-will inside me that is trying to assert itself when the preaching of the word of God is going on, that self-will must die if we're going to get to the kingdom of God. That's why Jesus said, he that loveth his life shall lose it, and he that hateth his life in this world shall keep it unto life eternal. If any man serve me, let him follow me, and where I am, there shall also my servant be. If any man serve me, him will my Father honor. I pray that you'll have this in your life in Jesus' name. We're looking at Acts of the Apostles chapter 20. Acts of the Apostles chapter 20. And I'm reading from verse 22. Acts chapter 20, verse 22. And now behold, I go bound in the Spirit unto Jerusalem, not knowing the things that shall befall me there, save that the Holy Ghost witnesses in every city, saying, the bounds and afflictions abide me. But look at verse 24. But none of these things move me, neither count I my life dear unto myself, so that I might finish my course with joy. He said, what's important to me is to finish my race with joy. What's important to me is to finish my course with joy. I'm committed to that. He said, about my physical body, forget about that. About pleasure, forget about that. About convenience or comfort, forget about that. He says, what's important to me is so that on the final day, I'll get to that heaven. I will wear the crown. And you're going to win and wear the crown in Jesus' name. That's why he said, and the ministry which I have received of the Lord Jesus to testify the gospel of the grace of God. Galatians chapter 2, I'm reading from verse 20. Galatians chapter 2. We're reading verse 20. Galatians 2, verse 20. I'm crucified with Christ. The self-life has to be crucified. I am crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live. Yet not I, but Christ liveth in me. And the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by the faith of the Son of God who loved me and gave himself for me. You see the demand of the Christian life, the commitment, the consecration, the absolute surrender, that we lay everything we have, we lay it on the altar and we say, Lord, all for you completely. And whatever you demand of me, Lord, I'm crucified with Christ. And now the life I now live, I live by the faith of the Son of God, because he loved me and gave himself for me. 2 Timothy chapter 2. 2 Timothy chapter 2, we're reading from verse 11. It's a faithful saying, if we be dead with him, we shall also live with him. Dead with him. Let the self-life die. Let that propensity, you let it die. The one that wants to assert your authority, let it die. And say, Lord, let all this die and let me live for you and for you alone. Look at verse 12. If we suffer, we shall also reign with him. If we deny him, I pray you'll not deny him. I said, I pray you'll not deny him. If we deny him, he also will deny us. If we believe not yet, he abideth faithful. He cannot deny himself. We're looking at Philippians chapter 3. Let's see the consecration of Paul, what your consecration ought to be. The commitment of Paul, what your commitment ought to be. In Philippians chapter 3 verse 7, but what things were gain unto me, those I counted loss for Christ. Paul the apostle could mention them one by one. His position in the Jewish religion, his authority of the Jewish Senate, and all the things that he had, he said, I had to give them up so I can follow Christ. Can you point to anything in your life you have given up? Anything profitable? Anything that makes you like a VIP, you have to give it up? Anything that, you know, puts you up there, you have to give up? That's what Paul the apostle did. That's the consecration. That's the absolute surrender. What he wants us to lay down so that we'll be able to inherit the kingdom. He said, what things were gain unto me, those I counted loss for Christ. Yea, doubtless, in verse 8, I count all things but loss for the excellency of the knowledge of Christ Jesus my Lord, for whom I have suffered the loss of all things, and do count them but dung, that I may win Christ and the reward that will follow Christ. I come to number 3 now. That's the our coronation and our crown. Our coronation and our crown. We're looking at Revelation chapter 3. Revelation chapter 3. I'm reading to you from verse 11. Revelation chapter 3 verse 11. Behold, I come quickly. Hold that fast which thou hast, that no man take thy crown. What you have, he says, hold fast, so that nobody will take your crown. Nobody will take your crown in Jesus' name. If you have been a Christian for maybe 5 years now, and then something has just come to your life, and then you let go of your consecration, of your commitment, of your obedience to the word of God, and of your vigilance over the doctrines of the word of God, because of something that just came into your life, and just because of this little thing, you're not holding on until the very end. Will you be a wise man or a foolish man? You can think of that yourself. If you've been a Christian for 20 years, for 25 years, for 30 years, and then you just got something now, and then because of this, you know, maybe it's money that is coming in, maybe it's property coming, maybe it's political position coming in, or whatever it is coming in your life, and because of this new thing that comes into your life, all the commitment and all the decisions of 30 years and 40 years or 50 years in the Lord.
You have received the message from our pastor, Pastor W.F. Kumoye, the General Superintendent of the Parallel Bible Church. It is my wish that as you listen, you accept the old word and you will let them sink into your heart. And by the grace of the Lord, you will never regret it. It is my prayer that by next week, when our pastor shall come up again to present another message, you will be there, your family will be there, and your friends. And I believe as you are listening to the message every week, by the grace of the Lord, you will never be the same. Let us pray. Our dear Heavenly Father, we thank you, O Lord, because of today's message. We thank you, O Lord, because of the one you let us listen to last week, and the one we are going to listen to the next week, by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. If you tarry, we shall listen together once again next week. And if not, every one of us will be there with you in the kingdom of God in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, because you are the Lord that answers prayer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.